The shadow slowly crept towards the office room at Starfleet headquarters. The shadowed man unveiled himself. Archer looked up to see a familiar yet distant face. Archer immediately began realizing who he was looking at.
Oh my god. Daniels? Hello, Captain. It's been a long time. I'm not gonna lie, I think about you every year around the same time, on and off. I'd always wondered if I'd ever see you again. And I would follow up that thought with, if I never see him again, then I suppose all is right with the world, and that's a good thing. Well, sir, you're right to be nervous. I am here because something is wrong. I had a feeling you'd say that. Gonna drop by for just a hi and hello. Maybe reminisce. Give me a secret recipe from the future that tastes so good it makes you smile for an hour. Maybe come tell me about my grandchildren and how great they're doing. Or my great-great-grandchildren. But no, it's gotta be bad news. Well, Daniels, what is it? You have no idea how long I've been waiting to speak with you. When my equipment was sabotaged, we were attacked by other time criminals. Time criminals? Yes, sir. You're telling me that the temporal Cold War is still happening? Not necessarily the temporal Cold War. The fight to preserve the timeline is an ongoing thing, Captain. It will probably never end, of course. But this was something different, and I'll brief you more on it at a later time, but allow me to continue. Go ahead. After I was attacked by these time criminals, I was sent back in time 25 years before today. It was during one of your final missions on Enterprise. I've waited those 25 years for this very moment to contact you. Why couldn't you say something as soon as you were sent back in a time? If I had contacted you at any other point, Captain, there would have been even more severe penalties for our future. You have no idea how hard it was to not reach out as every year passed. There have been several events that have been out of place or that have been altered in the timeline that are negligible. However, there are a few issues. Some of these issues aren't even felt until hundreds or thousands of years in the future. Because when I was sent back, I was in the middle of my calculations, my data is incomplete. Now, I'm still not sure why this is. We know this. It all starts with the Enterprise interfering with the abduction of Shran's daughter. She was supposed to die. Why would Shran's daughter's death matter so much? There's no way we can do anything about that now, and even if I could, I wouldn't. Captain, these are events that must be corrected. I shouldn't be here. Please, Captain, you have to listen to me, and we don't have a lot of time. Are you serious? What do you want me to do? Go back in time and kill Shran's daughter? I haven't seen you in 25 years. Now you show up here telling me that the death of one of my dear friends' daughter is impeccable to the future? It may not have to be, Captain. I'm an admiral now. Admiral Jonathan. Well, Daniels, from my vantage point, history worked out pretty well. Trip wasn't supposed to die, Admiral. What?
It's been a long road. getting from there to here, it's been a long time, but my time is finally near, and I will see my dream come.